Hello, this is Mark Wildman of Wildman Athletica, and today we are going to do a nerd math video. We are going to talk about our reverse ladder, which we use to do our basic training for our heavy kettlebell clean and press. Our reverse ladder is a very simple strategy where we start hard and we make our life easy over time. This is the best strategy to do with heavy weights, or any weight for that matter. We are starting with whatever weight we have when we are running the same math program over and over and over again. It's simple, it works. In barbell training, you would normally do something like 5 sets of 5 or 3 sets of 3 or 5 sets of 3, and you would have a very simple mathematical program which you would do. With a barbell, you change the amount of weight on the bar, you keep the reps and the breaks all the same. We are not going to do that. Because we have a kettlebell, we have a fixed weight. We can't micro load, we can't add small increments of weight, we can't do any of that stuff. We have one weight, we have to figure out how to get good with it, so we have to do the math part. The way that we do that is we start with something very, very simple. So we start with 2 reps on each side, and then we go to 1 rep on each side. 2, 2, 1, 1. That adds up to 3 and 3 before you put the weight down, 6 total reps. The goal of kettlebells is always strength endurance. The goal is to do more reps without putting the weight down or get a heavier weight. But most people don't have heavier weights right now, so our goal is to figure out how to get better with the weights we have. Next up, you normally, where most people start is 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, 1. So 3 on the left, 3 on the right, 2 on the left, 2 on the right, 1 on the left, 1 on the right. 6 reps on each side, a total of 12. You'll notice your legs are staying under load the entire time. That's the point of doing hand changes with kettlebells. You never have to set the weight down. Then we progress to 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, 1. That adds up to 10 reps on each side, which is 20 total reps. Very simple. It's getting only 1 rep harder each time, which is the smallest increment we can do. There are no half reps in a kettlebell press. There can be half reps if you're some kind of weird bodybuilder who's trying to modify kettlebells into bodybuilding, but for the most part, we just don't do that. We do full reps of everything. That's kind of the point. And then 5, 5, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, 1, 15 reps on each side, 30 total reps before you put the weight down. That should take 2.5 minutes. That should probably take 2 minutes. That should probably take 1.5 minutes. Very simple math. We start with something easy. Usually this is where people start, but if people have contraindicators or previous injuries, we can start them down here. That's totally fine. People need to learn the hand change so that they can keep the weight up the entire time. That's the point of kettlebelling, endurance weightlifting. When you're on this, you add sets. You keep your rest period the same every time. I like 1 minute. If you're using a heavy weight, you could make it 2 minutes. But for the most part, anything under 24K works fine with a 1 minute break. You can get up to about 70 pounds before that 1 minute break starts to really fall apart. And you add more sets. So if you did 2 sets of 3, 2, 1, then you would do a total of 24 reps. Next time you would add it. Thank you. Thank you. Next time, get down there so they can see the board. Next time you would add another set and you would go from 24 total reps to 36 total reps to 48 total reps to 60 total reps, adding sets each time, keeping your rest period the same. When you got somewhere in that range, then you would go up and you would start again over at, say, 2 sets. 2 sets of 20 is 40, 3 sets is 60, 4 sets is 80, 5 sets is 100. And then when you get up here, we start with 2 to 3 sets and we build up. It's a very simple program. The goal is to get us up to at least 150 reps in a workout in a limited amount of time. Think about this being 2.5 minutes of time with a 1 minute break. That's 3.5 minutes per round. When you max it out at 5 minutes, you're at, what's that, 17.5 minutes? Did I do that math right in my head? So at the high point, this should take about 17.5 minutes to finish. That's very simple, it's very controllable, it's very realistic for most people who live in the modern world. Most people don't have 5 hours a day to train. If you're The Rock and you have 4 hours built into your day every day to train, go for it. Normal people don't have that. Normal people have to have time management skills. They have to be able to predict exactly how long everything is going to take. So if you take all of that stuff and you put it on a board, you complete all of those reps, then you go up and wait and you do it again and you keep doing it forever. This is very, very simple math program, but this is how you guarantee you get stronger. It's simple, it's effective, do the math. All of this math will be included in our app that's coming out. We're gonna have data tracking for all of this stuff. The idea that we wanna do is have, you're not helping. The idea is that we're gonna have all of this in there and we're gonna have fields for all the weights. So you're gonna be able to enter your weight and it's gonna then tell you what the next workout is. And you're gonna complete all the weights that you have. When you get a new weight, you enter it in, you start it all over again, and you just keep going. You can buy a new weight every month. It's very simple, it's very effective. This is how you do it. This is the math program for your fundamentals of strength for clean and press, for kettlebell, for single arm clean and press.